Good Monday, Cup of Sales Joe. Being centered. So what does that mean? And more specifically, what does it mean to you? When I ask this of people, it typically comes back with actions that create the feeling of being centered. And I do want to get to that in a bit. But first, I think it's useful to identify what we mean by the feeling of being centered. And to do that, I'm going to borrow from a couple of bands that do this extremely well, building a rhythmic and melodic center that they can wander from and return to. And I'll start with one of my favorites, Rush. Being centered is akin to having balance when we think about it purely from a physiological or physical standpoint. I can say that when I was training in martial arts, that being centered meant to have balance. It also meant a feeling of control. Many times we would use breath or connecting with our breath to center ourselves before we launched an attack or we did a break or we sparred. It was a feeling of supreme control and the ability to deal with external stimulus. For example, one of the key requirements at each level of martial arts is to do what's called a form. It's a beautiful and sometimes powerful series of movements all tied together almost like a dance. It is meant to show your abilities, including power, control, flexibility, quickness, and most of all with the ones I did, balance. Each movement would be done with coordination and balance. In other words, each move would be centered no matter what it was, a kick or a punch or some other movement. Even some of the stances that we had to perform within the form would show supreme centeredness and balance. I can remember one such stance where you had to be so balanced and strong that someone could stand on your back leg and your knee and you could hold their weight. It also applied when we were sparring or fighting that typically you would get hit or caught off guard when you were off balance or off center. In fact, complete martial arts are based on this principle, such as Hapkido or Aikido, in which you work from your center to throw your opponent off their center or off balance. I've even found myself recently discovering this principle in golf. When I can take just an extra moment to use my body and my breath to center myself, not only physically but mentally, I can then produce a much more productive and consistent result. Why am I going on about examples of this? Well, does this sound already like something we could use every day in our work? A centered and balanced and purposeful approach? You bet. But how do we do this? Hey Cup of Sales Joe, it's Scott, and I'm sure you have all experienced, just like I have, either in your hometown or while you're traveling, a little independent coffee house or coffee shop that you really enjoyed. The atmosphere, the vibe, and hopefully, especially, the coffee. Well, I have one of those that I frequent. It's called Mad Goat Coffee, and Sam the owner has been kind enough to allow me to offer my audience a special deal as they're about to open their third location as they continue to grow. So go to madgoatcoffee.com and use discount code CSJ to get 10% off anything. You can order mugs, apparel, other merchandise, and coffee. In fact, it's my favorite coffee. I'm enjoying right now their new Costa Rican light roast, which he just started roasting recently. I happened to get the very first bag. No matter your tastes, you can find something you'll love. And be supporting a small business. So visit madgoatcoffee.com and use code CSJ to save yourself 10%. Similar to the physical idea of being centered, with our work mentality, it's important that we don't get knocked off kilter by one thing or by something. This happens sometimes when we allow the urgent to control our day, or not having a plan, or allowing others to influence us unduly. When I think of someone operating in a very centered way, what comes to mind for me is someone who is measured and planned and purposeful. To do all of those things, we need to be connected with our plan and our purpose. Now, doesn't that sound easy? I mean, right now, where you are sitting, the idea of developing a plan, connecting to it, and executing on it each day or week seems simple. And it is. But then why do we not do it all the time? Well, several reasons, but many of those reasons have to do with things outside of our control, like other people, the world, the economy, you name it. You can come up with plenty of reasons why we don't do this. But let's focus on us, what we can control. And in fact, as I said before, control can be equated to balance or being centered. So, in reality, if you're having challenges with staying in control of things, or it seems like each day or week things begin to spiral out of your control, then let's frame this idea around being centered and balanced. And the greatest challenge we find to this is connecting regularly with what this looks and feels like. Beyond a mantra or a quote or a poster, really truly connecting with how operating this way feels, looks, sounds, hell, even how it smells. Let me ask you this. How do you stay connected to your goals? I have asked this of many people, and I get as many different answers as there are personalities. Vision boards, prayer, mantras, meditation, quotes, sticky notes. So I ask you, how do you stay connected? Or in other words, how do you stay centered and connected to what you want to accomplish or where you want to go? And most importantly, ask yourself, is it working? By the way, Rush is by no means the only artist I feel that establishes a musical center like this. If you are not reaching your goals, and if you feel like your work or your life is a bit out of control, then I'm guessing you could use a better way to do this. Now, if I also asked you, how do you keep track of your to-dos? Well, I already know what that looks like. We're all good at making those lists and working on them, right? But isn't staying centered and connected with our goals and our best selves as or more important than any single to-do on your list? And yet, we pay little or forget to pay attention to our big drivers, our prime movers, so to speak. Perhaps it's because we feel like that's a luxury. To take the time to center ourselves and connect with our mission and our big goals? Who has time for that? We are too busy working towards them. Well, towards something. The shiny and the temporary are urgent and designed and begging us to look at them. But to what degree we give in to that, and consequently, our own center of being suffers. Notice I say center of being, not center of doing. I also believe that being and staying centered is a sign of and requires us to have high self-awareness. We can only be as good as we know and believe ourselves to be. There is a confidence that comes from operating in a centered, balanced way. There is intentionality and purposefulness that is clear to others, even if not stated explicitly, that comes from this way of being. So first, identify. What is your center? state your purpose, your goals, your mission, and most importantly, what keeps you going. Then, and only after you have identified and clarified for yourself these things, find a way to keep this in your consciousness or keep it pinned in your work and your life. If your mission is strong enough, and here's the key, you can feel it, it will drive you and always attract you like a moth to a flame. So consider this a reminder to connect with this and find a consistent, easy way to connect with your center. This week, as you go about your work, play with ways to operate more from your center, incorporate it into everything you do. And practice patience and grace with yourself when you get lost. As always, have a centered and purposeful week. Whoa. I'm sure that you can use more about how to stay connected to your higher aspirations and your goals, how to stay centered. So, head over to my YouTube page, Cup of Sales Joe, and look for another cup, How to Stay Centered, and I'll see you there.